Brown and Walker, bring the train out from 16th, right?
Writers, because that's what they do. They write their names, among other things, everywhere. Names they've been given or have chosen for themselves. Most of all, they write in and on subway trains, which carry their names from one end of the city to the other. It's called bombing. And it has equally assertive counterparts in rap music and breakdancing. Graffiti writing in New York is a vocation. Its traditions are handed down from one youthful generation to the next. To some, it's art. To most people, however, it is a plague that never ends. A symbol that we've lost control.
I'm Detective Bernie Jacobs. I, in conjunction with my partner, Detective Jim McHugh, are the crime prevention coordinators for the New York City Transit Police Department. Graffiti, as the name itself, is not an art. Graffiti is the application of a medium to a surface. I will show you graffiti, such as the letters on the end of that car directly in back of me. Is that an art form? I don't know. I'm not an art critic. But I can sure as hell tell you that that's a crime.
At the Grand Concourse 149th Street station in the Bronx, graffiti writers gather at what they call the writer's bench.
They're saying that the kids run the subways, that the system is out of control, that 15 and 16 year old kids are running the system, and that graffiti is a symbol of that.
No, I ain't running the system.
Hell yeah.
I'm bombing the system. They're trying to make it look like graffiti writers break windows and everything. It ain't even like that.
You know who be doing that, man? Niggas who be high when they come from school,
right,
is the ones who break the windows.
And it's in the graffiti artist's favor to be as cool, calm, and collected about putting his art on the train as he can. You know, he wants to get in and get out without even being noticed, except for the work that's going to come out to the public, the, you know, that Monday.
Yeah, we gotta start to rock some straight letters.
This one came out alright, right?
That's, you know, yeah, that's the first, that's about the third scheme piece I did, this shit. And that's the TikTok I did in Gun Hill.
What'd you do last night?
We did two whole cars. It was me, Dez, and me, three, right? And then the first car in small letters, it said, all you see is, and then, you know, big, you know, black silver letters that said crime in the city, right?
It just took up the whole car?
Yeah, it was a whole car and shit. Then it was a, you know, a scroll, like, you know, one of those scrolls. Then in the next car, it was a scheme that had, you know, a cop character, you know, a police nigga with a stick, you know, in a bag.
What decides you put around the
society
car?
Should go down in the subway and lock them all up because they don't have any business down there. It is dangerous down there.
people that work down there 25 and 30 years have accidents. But his contention is that he's immortal, I guess, like most 17-year-olds are immortal.
Right? Well, it's a matter of getting a tag on each line and each division. You know, you go, it's called going all city. People see your tags in Queens, uptown, downtown, all over.
I can only laugh to keep from crying, because what happens is that I don't really think he knows how silly that sounds. He's going all city. I mean, to what end? And when I ask him, he says to me, well, just so people see it and they know who I am. Somebody knows who he is, and so they see it. And so
it's not a matter of so they know who I am.
So they see it, and then after they see it, so what?
It's a matter of bombing, knowing that I can do it, you know? Every time I get in the train, almost every day I see my name. I say, yeah, you know what, I was there, I bombed it. It's a matter, it's for me, it's not for nobody else to see. I don't care about nobody else seeing it or the fact if they can read it or not. It's for me and other graffiti writers that we can read it. All these other people who don't write, they're excluded. I don't care about them. You know, they don't matter to me. It's for us.
CC Starboard Bow.
Slow it down. Slow it down.
What is it? You tell me.
Nice and slow. Nice and slow.
This is it. This is it. This is it. This is it.
In the 1970s, New York graffiti, rapping, and breaking became the prime expressions of a new young people subculture called hip-hop. Graffiti is the written word. There's the spoken word of rap music. And then there's the acrobatic body language of dances like breaking.
It started in the Bronx and part of Harlem.
It started in Freeze's house.
Come on, shut up!
His mom takes the break. She's
all I can do.
Don't be talking about my mother now.
Well, yeah, Billy, go. Mom, you just been on that head about my mother.
Boy, you act is stupid now.
In the past, right?
Break is when you don't have nothing to do and, you know, everybody just stand around getting high. Just for you.
You make up your own freezes. You got names.
And you call them, you got names for them.
Like what?
Like
the baby.
What's a baby?
Check.
A dead freeze like this.
Well, that's one of the old ancient.
It ain't one of the old, because I was the first one to do it.
How ancient can you get? The one when you go like this?
It's called the hump.
It's called the
headache.
Hump.
Man, the headache. Where?
No, that's the headache.
That's the headache.
And the other one is the hump.
You got a headache.
Oh, you can be headache.
When you got a headache, you go like that, you know. When you hump, you go like that.
This is the transit system. They don't like it to be defaced, and they will at times try and go to the extreme and try and apprehend you. The subway system is a very old one, and I've personally explored some tunnels, and I've found rooms where maps that were so old it might have been like the first train line that New York City had. Call it what you want. Just a lot of rock, a lot of steel, tomb, dungeon, under the city. A lot of trains, a lot of fun. lot of art. Art that's going to be a part of New York City's history forever.
Oh, wow, check it out, our whole car, man.
Yo, what?
Check it out, man, the statue.
Yeah,
look at that, man. That's
big. A lot of writers have been down here, you can tell. Graffiti all over the place.
Oh, check it out.
Years ago, it was pretty much a secret. It was secretly done. People wondered and wished they could do it. Not most people do it. When all the toys are like home sleeping, cuddling to their pillows, they usually have curfews. Come down in the wee hours of the night after the work has done their job, sweep has done the sweeping they had to do. Just take my time and be creative.
I think it's something you can never really capture again once you experience it. You have like live third rails and like crazy cops who come and chase you out. Even the smell you get, like when you first smell trains, like in a yard, it's like, it's a good smell to like a dedicated graffiti writer, I guess. When you're first against the train, it's like, everything seems so big, like, wow. It's like you're in a yard of like metal giants and like, you're just like, I mean, everything is like so hard and like so steel and like, you're just there, you're like a little dude. You're like in the midst of all this metal and like, you're here to produce something, you know? Well, you're here to like, try to produce something.
Well, I've seen comparable graffiti. Not necessarily these particular ones. Each of these cost us $1 million, in a sense, because others went out and tried to copy. Isn't worth it. Well, it is one of the quality of life offenses, and you can't just take one of those quality of life offenses. It's like three-card Monte and pickpocketing and shoplifting and graffiti defacing our public and private walls. They're all in the same area of destroying our lifestyle and making it difficult to enjoy life, and I think has to be responded to. And so I've told you that the response that I think a repeater, three-time repeater, should get would be 5 days in jail. Now, obviously, a murderer, you, if you believe in the death penalty as I do, you want to have the option of executing a murderer. You wouldn't do that to a graffiti writer.
I saw your work over here. I just want to find out what you're filming.
Well, we're making a film on subway graffiti in New York.
But why did you take this particular neighborhood here? What's unusual? Is there more graffiti here than other places? I hope not.
We're here because one of the best graffiti writers lives around here. Writes Scene.
What is it?
S-E-E-N.
That's his name?
Yes, that's what he
wrote. Or is it a nom de plume?
It's a nom de plume.
You wouldn't tell me his real name.
No.
Why not? Would he be in getting trouble or wouldn't he be glorified by it?
Numerous reasons why I ain't painting right now. To make a long story short, I'm on what they call a six-month probation. Call it a six-month vacation, never mind probation. Now they got a graffiti squad on this line, which there really was never really. Since they come on the line, it's been harder to piece, and it ain't like the old days when a train used to pull into the yard on a Friday night. That train wouldn't pull out until Monday morning. Now when you go to piece a train, you put an outline on the train and you can say goodbye, the train pulls out in 10 minutes later. Or if you're ready to put an outline, you gotta chase the train halfway down the track to put an outline on the piece. It just ain't the same anymore. They don't know what they're doing no more. Late, as usual. If I'm here, I show up though. I show up. Let me see. Well, why don't you do this one, on that side of the wall. You know what I'm saying? No. This one. We got plenty of room, believe me.
The bottom of the piece?
The bottom of the piece, I say about here. All right, you know you're going to go a little bit below the top, because we're going to have it on a wave. You know what I mean? It's going to be big, the legs. So I want you to start from about here. All right, maybe even here. Start it from here. Listen to me, from here. You understand what I'm saying here?
I still think it's too big.
Now, your first outline is needed. Always needed. This way you know what you're filling in. No matter how good you are, you can't just go in and just start filling in the air. You gotta have your first outline. Once your first outline is done, then your filling, that takes away your first outline, meaning you don't need your first no more because now you got your filling. From your filling, you put your colors and then your 3D. And if you want background, you put your cloud or whatever. How's this, nigga? I'm throwing a few connections here. I wanna make it look like yours. What do you think? I'll make a few bits. All right. Huh? Bits. I don't know, little doodads here and there. Yeah, that now shape it up. I have about 100 outlines, but I'll shape it up. Nikki, come on. You gonna save me room or what? I didn't do that to yours. Get out of there.
He's making a mess in this house. He cannot sit down without, you know, doing graffiti on something.
All right, when
you really can't.
When you're talking on the phone, you don't doodle on the paper?
I don't doodle.
Yes, you do.
I do not doodle.
You do doodle on the paper.
I don't doodle.
I just write my name while I'm talking on the phone. What's that?
You're telling me that you write your name while you're talking on the phone. In the meantime, you have destroyed your room.
Testing out my paint.
You have no respect for anything. Don't tell me about testing out your paint. You have no respect for anything anymore.
Ain't we putting red, yellow, and up, red, orange, and yellow in here?
No, the brown's got to be brown.
I ain't putting no browns there. Ain't no way. Red, orange, and yellow. You want it to stand out.
Top,
boom.
On top.
Whole thing around the whole works. Red, orange, and yellow. Remember how I did the mad scene with the wall and the color went all around the thing? The mad scene went on the fives. With the walls were falling down, the one I did myself?
No.
All right, let me explain. Yellow, orange, and a little bit of red. Yellow and orange around the whole thing, and then we'll put browns and beiges in the 3D. Believe me, I'll show you. Not around the face, fade into the yellow, but a trim of red, a cheap trim, I'll show you after. All right? I'll never steer you wrong, Nick. Rust-Oleum, Krylon, Wet Look, Epoxy, Red Devil. When you hold a can of Rust-Oleum in your hand, it's like holding three other shit brands in your hand. It lasts, it covers, and it's not aerosol like Krylon. It just comes out in the mist. It just comes out like paint.
The schools have courses in art. How about the mothers and fathers of this city saying to the kids, that's the wrong thing to do?
You listen to them talk. They sound absolutely ridiculous. He's king of the yakety yak yard. I don't know who died and left him king of any yard. He owns nothing in the subway, you know?
I love robbing paint. I know, you know, everybody knows how he robs it. And, like, he gets me souped up, and sometimes I'll go and get 15 cans at a time, you know, stuffing it in your coat, in your shirt, down the back of your pants. It's mainly with a big coat and, like, 15 cans, you figure it out, it's like over $50. You going into stores, like we could go one day and get 100 cans at a time. It's easy, for me anyway. It's, you know, harder on black kids or Spanish kids, because like everybody thinks a graffiti writer is black and Puerto Rican, and that's like, you know, it's wrong, you know. A lot of white people are writing.
What you've got is a whole miserable subculture.
I was raised on the Upper East Side of Manhattan. I went to a sort of strict prep school in the Bronx, right, Riverdale Country School. In attending that school,
I had to walk past the one yard on 242nd Street every day. From where I stood, I'd watch the trains pull in and out. I thought, how could a human being have his name on every car? You know, that these guys must either live in there, be allowed to live in there, or just be, like, allowed to, you know, go off like that, right? They're trespassing it. They're beating the system. They're getting their names up, right? We've drenched the city with our names, right? We're trying our damnedest. Freshly painted double R, and we spent about 3 hours in it.
That's impossible.
No, it's not. We were tagging with the unis, then the minis, then the Marvies, then the pilots, then the flow pens, and we were doing clouds around the tags and 3Ds on the tags. We just, for the double R's to have a clean car back then like that, it was, we just had an orgasm.
1970. The idea of getting your name up, not just in your neighborhood, but everywhere, was invented by a kid named Taki, who lived on 183rd Street in Washington Heights. Taki 183. As soon as everybody understood that it was a name, they realized that Taki was famous.
Taki 183 was the first guy, even though they say Julio 204 started before him. But he was the one that made it famous. Then after him, in them times, was Papa 184. Then came up Junior 161. K-161, they were bombing too. Stitch came out around 1971, he was all 32. Barbara, Eva, 62, they were girls. Everybody was right. Oh, that was what everybody was talking in them days.
I got into graffiti just like riding the trains when I was younger, you know, looking at, you know, old writer shit, you know. Like a lot of new writers around, like they, you know, you talk to them about a lot of old writers, see, they don't even know what you're talking about.
I started in 1973 or 4, during very early years of initial bombing, very important years of graffiti bombing, because if it wasn't for those years, I don't think we would get where we are today.
That was the life back then. That was happening. Everybody was pioneering back then. That's when all your developing happened, your bubble letters, all that kind of stuff, your wild styles.
Wild styles. Yeah, you don't have to do straight letters to have style. Anything that comes in your imagination adds on to your own individual style. The arrow. Everybody's got their own arrow. I like that though. Various arrows. Some guys have on the letter arrow. That was their connection. Some people had different arrows just going right through their pieces.
The funk is here, so you can groove. We want to make your body move.
Colors, designs, style, technical,
just get loose.
Cartoons, everything. And when they see you got a vicious style, they be wanting to get loose about it, knowing that's what keep it
and
going.
That's graffiti.
Right, keep sparking it.
You know, I know a lot of good riders, you know, and all the riders that I knew, you know, they used to get up. So they used to tell me, yo, Trap, won't you get up? And I started getting up with them. We started doing pieces. Then I met Dez.
One
and then,
day. I came to the bench and I seen him sitting there looking at the pieces. You could tell a rider, you know, like you go to the bench and you see him as the trains go by, he be going like this. And
Oh, he have ink stains on his clothes.
He gave me outlines and stuff like that to practice.
I can't let him go for at least 5 minutes. You know, he'll destroy the piece. You know, I turn around, Chop, what you doing? You know, I want to do my own piece. I said, yeah, but you know, follow the outline. Rush, rush. What's up, man? You know, I'm chilling, man. Slick Rick, and the Asian B.
For about 2.5 years, I was upstate, from like beginning of 1970 to 72.
What's up? Yeah, what's up?
Polo, man.
When I came home, I ain't know nothing about no writing, no graffiti, because I wasn't about it.
All right, you know it. What's up, man?
So when I got home, I seen writing on the train. I said, what's this stuff here, you know? Those niggas doing their names big. I said, let me do one at least, you know, because I was, you know, down with art already. And I did me a piece, just, you know, for people in general to get to know who I am. I said, ooh, that look all right. Well, I'm going to go every Sunday now. Next thing I know, I started getting better and better. And as I realized I knew to get better, I said, oh man, I'm gonna bring out the computer rock. And then that's when I really got loose, because then niggas are saying, yo, who's that guy? Then one day, these news reporter people was on the train station. We was going by and we seen them. We seen them filming our whole car. We went up to them and I remember I said, yo, who you think probably done that right there, you know, just to be curious to see what they say? And he said, I don't know, but whoever done it, that's some remarkable talent, you know? I ain't never seen nothing like this before. I said, if I told you I did it, would you believe me? He said, I don't know, I can't say, but I believe so, because you don't never know what you can believe these days. So I said, well, I did. And then he said, I don't believe that, you only got one arm. I said, that don't mean nothing. I do things that people don't realize I can do with this, you know, being that I'm like this, you know? And then he said, I hear you then, Sonny. And then I said, well, I ain't no Sonny now. I just was asking a question, sir, you know? So that's all I wanted to know, see how your feelings was about it.
Do you want to dance? What's up? Get some candy? Huh? Ain't getting nothing? Wait up. Get some candy, man. You ain't got no chance? Oh. Hey, Juggalo, what you know? Juggalo, where that nigga at, man? Yeah, I dig it.
We're going on the other side, right?
Word. Wow, Juggalo, wow.
The Peacemaster, do you want to switch?
Yeah, look.
Are you willing to take a chance?
Instead of that eye, just...
Yeah, word, look at that eagle, word. That's the look at the eye, it's like his eye. Know where he got that from, right?
Okay.
From Golden Who? Frank Rosetta. Peacemaster.
Where the letters is breaking
up. Epic Adventures of a New Kind of Hero. That's what we're going to be, the fresh extraterrestrial brothers. You know what I'm saying? Extraterrestrial, knowing we're the best. You know what I'm saying?
It's the Desi Dez and the KCK, the D5. We gonna rock the place. And if you're based in the place, you will get disgraced, because we are the crew. We got the place.
Rock, sock it, rock it in the pocket.
What that girl front of train, took it to the doctor, so I'm on again. Stabbed that man right in his heart, gave him a transfer for a brand new start. Can't cut through the park,
cause it's crazy after dark. Keep my hand on my gun, cause they got me on the run. I feel like an outlaw, broke my last glass jaw. Hear them say, you want some more? Living on a seesaw. Glass everywhere, people pissing on the stage, you know they just don't care. I can't take the smell, can't take the noise, got no money to move out, I guess I got no choice. Rats in the front room, roaches in the back, junkies in the alley with the baseball bat. I tried to get away, but I couldn't get far, cause a man with a tow truck repossessed my car. Don't push me, cause I'm close to the edge. I'm trying not to lose my head.
Graffiti, man.
Niggas say it played out, niggas say this, niggas say that. But it's gonna keep going on, you know? But look, I might be old and quit, you know, but you coming up, younger niggas is coming up, it's gonna keep going and keep going, you know? But you gonna be a king soon too, you know?
He's like a son to me in a way, you know. I look out for him, he looks out for me. You know, I won't let nothing happen to him, you know. You know, he won't let nothing happen to me if he could help it, you know. I know from his age, he's 14 now, you know, and I'm 16. By the time he get my age, he'll be like one of the best people out, you know. And if he continues to go on in the years, he could be another Picasso.
Life ain't no more joke, it's a serious thing when you're dealing with an accident.
And competing for the best style is the key to all forms of rocking. For the rap MC, it's rocking the mic. For the B-boys, it's rocking your body and breakdancing. Or for writers, rocking the city with your name on a train.
Get funky in the place. Get funky in the place.
Right now he's doing the footwork with the original breaking came out. Yeah, he's doing the baby and the turtle.
Back bridge.
Yeah, did the head spin and then just went up.
I got a certain backspin that I made up. Want me to show you it? I started off doing like this. And landed like that. So then I just decided not to do the freeze and keep on spinning. So it goes like this. I put my arm right here, and it's easy, and I'm pushing my arm and swing my left leg to my right leg, both of them around. Bring your leg.
Other crews, they're not as good as us, you know, because we have the breaking form, you know, the
original break, style.
Yeah, original
Most
style, you know.
Original.
Other crews, like Dynamic Rockers, you know, they bite usually.
Yeah, they bite. Let me tell you about these people.
Dynamic Rockers.
1, 2, 1, 2. 1, 2, 1, 2, party people in the base. Rock steady against Dynamic Rockers. Rock on to the breaking door. Crazy Lace in the house.
This goes back when I used to go out to the roller scene, United States of America and Queens, right? I used to go over there to break against all of them and take them all out, you know, burn them, make them look stupid. I mean, they had no kind of style at all. They was beginners. I've been breaking way before them.
We started doing better routines than they were. They got to a point where they got mad at us because we was taking them out with our moves, and then that started getting out of hand because they had the crowd and we didn't.
Yo, whoever ain't in rock steady or dynamic, get behind the barriers.
Yo, both rock crews, can you please listen? Yo, nobody's listening to me. We're not gonna start until you move. Rockies, get ready.
Upright, it's just like humiliating, you know, doing things in people's face and all that. And down rocking is, you know, trying to see who can compete against whose moves on the floor.
Who's looking out when they run a 30-day cold? All of a sudden, there was a knock on my door. It was Son of Sam, a winner for the fall. The enemy threw a hole straight through my door. So I went to the back to get the gun. I was out two bullets, had only one. I shoot the shit, yeah, shot him in his eye. Levers on white man, jump so high.
So who won the rocking contest?
Took them out, right?
Put it this way, we're out of sight and they bite.
They bit my turtle into a hot.
Oh, niggas is biting
man,
to their legs.
I could have cried when I seen it. You know that faggot that was flying around there with his funny legs and shit?
Yo, man. So what?
That's not even breaking, man. That's all fairy flying. I call that fairy flying.
Who goes for rock steady?
T.O. Mike C.
Hey girl, hey girl.
Peso.
B.L.B.
Rockin' it, yes, he is rockin' it.
Tito
rockin' it, yes, he is rockin' it.
Mike C.
Rockin' it, yes, he is rockin' it.
Peso.
Rockin' it, yes, he is rockin' it. We're all rockin' it, you should be rockin' it, rockin' it.
Overnight. Do you wait for the same train coming back into the same station?
No, you get the park train and you just...
Oh, you mean you go to the
train yard? Yeah, like the lamp or the train yard.
Does your mother wonder why you come home with that all over your face?
No, she knows I write the graffiti. I told her. I said, I'm going up on the train, so I'm going to go write some graffiti.
Does she ever worry you might get in trouble?
Yeah. She says if the cops call, I'm going to come running to me.
I never realized it meant so much to them, you know? I just thought they were writing anything. But I guess it has a deep meaning. Huh?
What kind of deep meaning?
Well, like he said, he's writing his girlfriend's names, and he's dust, whatever that means. What is dust supposed to mean?
It's just a name. It's a word, you know? It's a game. It's like they give you a name, and they say, here, take this name and do something with it. Like, he got the name Scene. He can walk around and just say, hey, my name is Scene. And I say, yeah, I see you back there, I see you there. It's a name. It's just like, I'll give you a name and you say, hey, how big could you get this name up? How high?
Trains are routinely washed, but because of the graffiti problem, we have to use a graffiti removal solution, which at best is detrimental to the physical makeup of the train itself.
This is what I'm assigned. The car wash. 8 a.m. to make a yard. Hold your nose.
We spend a lot of money replacing broken and damaged side windows. We cannot use acrylic plastic windows in the train because the same graffiti removal solution fogs the windows.
The problem often is that often it doesn't produce a sparkling, clean car, but rather a sort of vomitous color, which is some of the graffiti artists argue less attractive than what they consider to be their artwork. So it's altogether sort of an unsatisfactory result.
Watch out, you might get wet. Watch your shoes. You got the best smelling stuff, but so far it hasn't hurt. You know, it hasn't...
That's my money that's being diverted from providing me with good, safe, secure, rapid transit.
Look at this junk. Graffiti doesn't make your life better. It just makes your neighborhood look worse.
You know how I made something out of my life? By using my hands.
But only in the ring. Don't use them to mess up the walls with graffiti.
I practiced all my life to make moves like that.
And I worked every day to be a singer.
So if you really want to make something out of your life, use your head.
Or your voice. But don't waste your time making a mess.
Make your mark in society, not on society. This happens to be a poster that is the first in a series that's going to be used in New York City subways and buses, where we've used Hector Camacho, who's a boxer, North American lightweight champ, and Alex Ramos, boxer, leading middleweight contender. Take it from the champs. Graffiti is for chumps. Make your mark in society, not on society.
It's really very clever. Put your mark on society in doing something in society. I've screwed it up a little bit, but nevertheless, you got the message.
Realistically, you think it can work.
Well, you say realistically, I'm hopeful that it will work. Nobody thought that we would be as successful as we were in the campaign against the drought and water conservation. Nevertheless, if that worked, I'm hopeful we will have equal success here. Time will tell.
Mr. Mayor, are those posters graffiti-proof?
Time will tell.
What you doing, B? Fresh?
Yeah,
that's
one of my little signature series,
guys. Word. No, son, you getting fresh on a nigga, man. That nigga still got the touch, boy. Butchie Butch with the tiger skin.
I see you did the case with the seats this time.
Yeah, well, you know who I am, though, anyway. You know the king of what? K King of style. Shoot, I got styles already that's more complex that nobody know about. I mean, super duty tough work. See, this is just semi, like what I would call it, but if I really get into it and start camouflaging it, I don't think you'd even be able to read it. Don't go nowhere. Little semi thing here. It wasn't no severely bad accident, it's just that I got burnt by wires, that's all. A long time ago, electrical wires, and then they rushed me to the hospital and they just had to amputate. Cause my tissues and muscles was burnt bad. You know, I was young, I was playing, and I wasn't, you know, too sure on what I was. I knew what I was doing, but I just didn't know not should I grab a wire or not. And I don't know if I grabbed it or not, but I know I just, you know, got hurt. Cause it had knocked me out, so I didn't remember, you know. But it don't mean nothing in general. I mean, I'm okay. It's just that it was a bad thing to happen at the time, you know? But that's why people is amazed about me now, because of going through that and then dealing with what I'm dealing with, even though it's common little bull crap in a way, you know. People look at a person, what? You ran on trains? Are you vandalism and all that? Yeah, I'm vandalism, all right, but still in general, I know what I'm doing. I did something to make your eyes open up, right? So why is you talking about it for, you know?
This is a beautiful spot to do pieces on. It ain't hardly no writers know about this place. My spot. Niggas know, believe it. Niggas know. Yo, here, take the cans. I am not a graffiti artist. I'm a graffiti bomber. There's two styles of graffiti that are trying to, you know, coexist with each other, but it ain't gonna work like that. Blood wars, buddy. Blood wars.
That's why graffiti's ruined. Like Cap ruined the twos and fives. The twos and fives used to go to the 2 yard. It would be like a masterpiece art gallery of burners from all these dudes from the Bronx and Brooklyn with Def Wild styles. Now you go to the 2 yard, it's all destroyed. This guy named Cap with his Lucille Ball hairdo. All your burners.
What's up, Sal?
What's up? What's up, man?
Seen your new pieces, man, on the 2s and 5s.
Yeah. Like, they went over that shine, man.
Yeah, I know.
Cap.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind if you would've went over one of my old cars, you know, but that was fresh. It was a brand new burner. It only ran for 2 days, you know? And he didn't even get a chance to run on the line, just like, you know, and they went over and I feel, you know, that hurt me, you know. And Scene was with him and PJ. And then I called Scene up and he denied it.
I can't afford to get involved. There's a war going on, as you should know. PJ and Cap against everybody.
He just crossed me out anyway, so I don't know why, but brand new car too, he wasted.
Let's say this. I stand behind them if they had a good cause for the situation. As far as it is now, they have no cause behind it. They're just doing it for the hell of it, which that ain't me because I wouldn't want people to go over my pieces, so I wouldn't go over them.
He's disrespecting the line, which no other guy was doing that years ago.
All he does is silver throws. You got fresh colored pieces full
of
top and
bottom. No, you can't get him back. You can't make up for what
he does. He'll just laugh at you. It's just a throw up. I got a million of them running, so what?
He's a jealous toy, that's all. Because he can't do a burner and shit.
He can't do shit.
He can't even do a straight letter.
He went over this?
Yup, he did a cap throw up over me and an NPC over this and wrote War next to Fat Albert.
Oh, shit.
You get him, man.
You can't never make up for that.
You gotta get that nigga on the permanent.
That's never
permanent.
Forgive action.
If you a toy, it gotta be stopped. And this guy's a toy, and he's big, and he's still gotta be stopped.
He gotta be stopped.
Regardless.
got breaks.
Yo, but how come we waited all this long? How come there's so many writers that he went over their burners and we're not in his neighborhood with crews?
Because nobody wants to get united. That's shit.
We gotta get together, bro. Shit.
Everybody says, yeah, we're gonna get down. We're gonna get down, right? But nobody comes, man. Yeah. Like, what we gotta do is meet everybody in 149th Street at the bench. It's like Grand Concourse.
We should forget all our other bullshit worries that we got with each other and unite and get this toy because he's fucking everybody.
Cap, I don't know, some big white boy. I don't know. I don't know. I don't want to know. Yeah, that's what he's doing, trying to get attention and revenge because people go over his dogs. You know, people do burners. You see a dog, you're going to go over it. Who thinks caps and dogs are worth being on a train? Nobody.
What you write, bro?
All right, man, man. Mayor.
Mayor?
Yeah.
M-E-A-R?
M-A-R-E.
M-A-R-E?
Yeah.
Mar.
Man. Man, Mar is M-A-R. But nah, seriously, you know, you gotta kill them dudes for doing that.
Who's Cap?
Cap.
Cap is right here?
People don't know what I look like until now. Until they start going to the movies. They're gonna see my face. Big deal. Anybody tries to screw around with me and my friends, I go over everything they got forever. Everybody from Brooklyn to Manhattan. Everybody. That's the way it is. Especially with me. The object is more. Not the biggest and the beautifulest, but more. It's like a little piece on every car is what counts. Not one whole car on every 30 cars that goes by. Once you start going over someone, you can't stop. So I'm gonna live. Dust started pulling some shit with me, and I'm telling you, he's lucky you didn't catch him by that wall. Because if we would have been, even if you were shooting a movie, it would have just been boom, boom, boom. And that's the way it would have went.
He's gonna get crossed off, I guarantee, by tomorrow, once they find out he's here.
Help me with the 3D, Nikki, come on.
The piece has got a lot of colors to go in there yet. But with the color, we could do that. We could do that with no problem. I could do it before it gets dark, no problem. Colors, colors, colors! Colors!
That was a beautiful wall. I really like that. People like that, they deserve getting everything they got crossed out. Forever.
For the past 20 years, there really hasn't been anything hot. There have been no movements since pop art. Any retailer, and let's face it, a gallery is indeed a retailer. They're always looking for something hot that they can merchandise and sell to the public.
It's almost as though these pieces were peeled off the train and put onto canvas. So you have the same energy, you have the same coloring, you have the same intensity and the same big piece that you would see on a train.
The real subway graffiti that's done on, you know, on the trains is slowly dying out, and this is taking its place. The lifespan of an average piece today only lasts a few months. This is something that could last a lifetime.
Blondie seems to be an important figure within the graffiti art style. Kane has used her in a very photographic way. Knock shows her expressionistically. I'm a colorist myself, I'm an artist. And it's exciting, the color is exciting, the movement is exciting, it combines all kinds of movement.
We had ABC TV, we had CBS here tonight. You know, we're going to be on the news tonight at 11 o'clock. National Public Radio.
Do it up, baby. I love it.
I'm Ron Powers. I'm a reporter with the Associated Press.
How long would it take you to do something like this?
On a train? Depends on what your schedule is. Like, I can't let my mother know that I'm going to the train, so I have to be back early.
A
but I did meet a guy here who's an art critic from the news, and he says he gets so goddamn mad every time he sees this that he walked up to one of the artists at the show tonight and said, how would you feel if I took a can and wrote on your graffiti? And the artist said to him, I kill you, man.
As an investment, I feel so strongly that if you get in on the bottom of anything, it's got to be a good investment, and this is definitely going someplace.
But I think that graffiti on the subway cars were a symbol of New York for foreign people, and especially French people. And I think it's a little sad if graffiti are going to be only on canvas and not anymore on trains.
Forget about the trains. Who wants to be dirty and hot at the same time?
That's right. I'm into making money.
Yeah, it feels good. You go to school and your teacher says, it's not worth anything.
Don't believe it.
You don't make any money from graffiti.
Yeah, that's
and you tell
right,
him,
boy.
When was the last time you made $2,000 in a month,
yeah,
huh?
Like making four and some change.
And you go, okay, now you failed.
All right, the thought has crossed my mind. Yeah, if something should happen, yeah, I'll go along with it. But if it doesn't, it's no thing to me, because that's not what I'm out here for. I'm out here to bomb, period. That's what I started for. I didn't start writing to go to Paris. I didn't start writing to do canvases. I started writing to bomb, to destroy all lines. And that's what I'm doing.
How long do you think you'll do it?
Till I'm finished.
Now that you've heard that, you understand what I'm saying to you when I say that I don't understand him. He's out there to bomb, destroy all lines. What have the lines ever done to him? What have the lines ever done to him?
Pay 75 cents.
When do you pay 75 cents?
Never, but...
Well, so I don't even know what you're talking about.
We're on the Staten Island Ferry. This is the New York Harbor. This is to signify we're leaving New York with this package of artists to go out and play places where individually they never would play. It'll be in Washington, D.C., Pittsburgh, Chicago, Madison, Minneapolis, Iowa City, Detroit, and Toronto.
Being professional, what does that mean?
Getting paid for what you do. Professional.
Having your own style.
Yeah. And
doing your own moves.
Don't let nobody else bite from you.
Doing it for a long time, knowing what you're doing. Being the best.
Special K, Sunshine, Kumo D. All time, feel the heartbeat. Feel the heartbeat with the treacherous threes. We got a new heartbeat. Get loose, get loose, Mosty, get loose. Just pop heartbeat, show you got juice. And have fun,
have fun,
have fun,
have fun,
have fun.
Party people got a brand new treat.
Off a well-known tune we call heartbeat.
But we jazzed it up and we broke it down.
It came out with a brand sound.
Now I came here to get this straight.
Our heartbeat's not on a normal rate.
Cause when we get excited, our adrenaline flows.
And this is the way our heartbeat goes.
The hop, skip, and the jump.
But not play no ball.
But a bump,
bump, bump, bump, bumpity
bump. It's a brand new treat.
And it sounds so sweet.
The rap and the music, our new heartbeat.
So feel the heartbeat, so feel the heartbeat. With the treacherous three, we got a new heartbeat.
Huh. Consider the professionals.
I think it's about time the politicians came down and looked and saw what is on these trains. It is this problem.
It shouldn't be that way. It should be cleaned, and the ones that are caught should be cleaned. They should clean it, the ones that they catch are doing that.
What's the sense of paying 75 cents when you have to ride graffiti trains, you know?
It gives a terrible impression of the city. And if you think the outside is bad, I've been riding them, like I say, for 40 years. The inside is it's just unbelievable.
It's a violation of public property.
I think it's disgusting.
They should at least get somebody to clean up the damn place.
We move 3.5 million people a day. They have rights, too.
The people see the outside of the cars when the trains are going, stop, pull into a station, or when they're passing on the express track. I mean, it's generally a blur, but I don't think the public finds that nearly as intrusive and ugly as they do the inside graffiti.
He hates the inside.
He hates the inside.
Yeah.
He said that if any possible way of we giving him some kind of suggestion of how to get rid of the inside, he said there might be a chance of negotiating with the outside.
Negotiating.
Something like that.
I met with a group of them one day, more out of intellectual curiosity as to who they were and what made them tick. I found them surprisingly articulate. They expressed a strong sense that if their outside paintings were left untouched, that the public would be impressed.
We came up to him with like a proposal to paint 10 cars inside and out and let it run in like the major stations.
And let people vote on it, like let's say during a 2-week period. And after the 2-week period, they'll have, you know, the results in the paper. And I think the MTA will be embarrassed.
I thought there was no basis whatsoever in which it was proper for anyone to touch our property in an unauthorized fashion.
They got guys out there that are mugging people in the subways, stabbing people, throwing people into the tracks and all that.
Right there.
And they're wasting their bullshit money trying to get us.
With all respect, I think you are close to falling into the sort of trap of the 1960s culture, which says, you know, this society has left these kids with not enough to do. If the kids have energy and want to do something, we'll give them all brooms, we'll give them all sponges, and they can do something that is publicly productive, useful, and that would earn for them the respect and approbation from their fellow citizens. It isn't the energy that is misplaced, it's the value system that is misplaced.
For the riding public to be up on the station one cold and dreary day and see a nice white shiny car come pulling up to the station.
The public has knocked us for so long and we are doing nothing. We couldn't be done. We proved that we've done it.
We painted 409 cars in approximately 8 weeks. 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and not one day did we miss that production schedule.
Our personal pride was hurt. A lot of people have been knocking the transit authority. And we wanted to show them that we could do something.
See, if the Japanese can do it, we can do it.
The stuff is like razor blades, about 2 inches long, and there's one of these every 2 inches. There's really not too much protective clothing you can wear to prevent yourself from getting cut. And once you do fall into it, it's so structured that it collapses upon you. And the more you try to move, the worse off you become.
Just like, you know, when you see in the movies, like in Apocalypse Now, how they used to protect their lines and their barricades. They want to hold back the enemy from destroying our trains.
About 3 years ago, I decided to suggest to Dick Ravitch that they put a dog in the yard to keep the graffiti vandals out. The MTA rejected it, and they said that if you put a dog in the yard, the dog would step on the third rail. Now, I don't happen to think that dogs step on the third rail, but I said in response to that, well, if you think the dog will step on the third rail, then build two fences and have the dog run between the two fences, and that will keep people out and protect the dog from stepping on the third rail. And the response was, well, maybe somebody will climb over the fence and the dog will bite them. I said, well, I thought that's what the dog was for, but if you're afraid of having the dog bite such a vandal, and here I called upon my prodigious memory. I said, what you should do then, instead of using a dog, is to use a wolf. And have a wolf run between the two fences, because there is no recorded case in history where
a wolf has ever attacked a human being unless the wolf were rabid, mad. Now, as a result of telling that story innumerable times, I embarrassed the MTA into building the fence around the first of 19 yards. And it was so successful, they now claim it as their own idea, and they're building 18 more fences.
I think it's stupid. The idea of having all this barbed wire and fences and protection, trains are still going to get ridden on.
They invented the white elephant. It's still got, well, they weren't bombed, but they had little mosquito bites. I mean, call it what you want. They were still ridden on. They're still not spotless completely.
Dumb Koch. Yeah, there you go. That is the highest praise imaginable, because obviously I'm getting to them.
There always will be graffiti. It's a part of New York. It'll be there forever. Someone will always want to jump down on a track or while the train's moving and just take out a can of paint or a marker and put up their initial.
He still shows me all his things, which I don't even want to see. But we still talk. I think he tells me just about everything that goes on. Other than that, I wouldn't really be able to tell you so much. And like sometimes, and knowing all this, right, it just really only makes me that much more fearful for him.
I felt that I just had to let him know, you know, like, because sometimes when it's time to go bombing, you know, you got to go late at night, like in the middle of the night, you got to leave the house at 2 o'clock just to go bombing so you don't get caught. You know, she got to know where I'm going. Can't just say I'm going to a party. No parties don't start at 2 o'clock.
Not every kid would tell his mother where it's going.
Yeah, well, I'd rather let my mother know what's going on, you know, than to keep in the dark. If I get busted, cops call, excuse me, we have your son for graffiti. You know, I'd rather, you know, let her know that I was doing it, so, you know, she's prepared to come and get me up. But never getting busted, so don't have to worry about that.
I mean, an adult, I just couldn't see an adult ever, like, putting that much energy to something that isn't going to pay or is going to risk their life or have, like, possibility of them getting arrested.
Well, I see myself as eventually growing out of graff and getting married and living the lifestyle, you know, and making good money like that. And when life is in its best, you don't really want to run around in the trains. I'm sure I'll come back every now and then just to let people know I'm still around.
Oh, no, when I come back, I take over, and that's it, after that. And after that,
you want
after
the
that,
of the six. I'm king right here. I'm the prince of the six.
After that,
he's later. You know, he's what a has been.
I'm what they call a has been, and he's a wannabe.
A wannabe.
They consider you a king.
Put it this way, I am a king. I can
king
say.
Of what?
I want to tell you, I am a king of bombing.
You got to be able to take over a line with insides, take it over with throw ups, top to bottoms. You gotta do everything, you know. If you specialize in one thing, you know, you really can't call yourself an all-out king.
Who's king? You looking at him right here, my brother, the original. You know what I'm saying? Kingdom Islam, nation God, for I'm the one that rocked so far, you know what I'm saying? Always rocking the jazziest quartet, you know what I'm saying? The only and the original magnetic king, and that's the one that's still sitting here doing his thing.
My next door, I promise, motherfucker.
You know it, tell him we all live. This is the original old master killer of the Manila Driller right here that you're looking at. The original king and loves to do his thing. Don't shout, don't run, don't hide, don't sky. This is me coming to you natural and live on CB. Whatever. Can he be without the mic?